なくても、そっくり。え？That strange sound is actually Apple's earliest computer. It's programmed. Meaning that they had a piece of circuitry designed to do a specific function. That's the difference.Seen these a lot, right? A good example of this calculator. Basically, an example of a fixed program. Does a reciprocal. You want to play video games on it? Good luck. You want to do word processing on it? Good luck. It's designed to do specifically fixed program computer. But a lot of the other really interesting early ones similarly have this flavor. Give an example.I never know how to pronounce this. That's awesome. One of the earliest computational things was this thing designed by a guy named Adam Aslop. Basically, solved linear equations. Anything to do, you can do 18 of one. Right? Six or whatever you want to do those things. All the computer was solved with equations. My favorite example was a computer by Alan Turing. Right?Which was designed to break code. It wasn't to break German sequence code, but it was designed to solve that specific problem. What I'm trying to make it, fixed program computers is where we started, but it doesn't yet. It's where we'd like to be. So it's a technical idea of what's possible. So let's see how we get there. So even within this framework of given a description of a computation set of steps,It's the idea that I could build a circuit. And let me suggest we will give a wonderful circuit. Suppose you could build a circuit with the following properties. Input to this circuit would be any other circuit diagram. If the circuit diagram is of something given to this circuit. And that circuit would wonderfully reconfigure itself to act like a circuit diagram. I mean, it could act like a calculator. It could act like a Turing solver. It could act like a circuit.What would that circuit look like? Imagine some tiny little robots wandering around, nice little wires and pulling up not getting different. How would you build a circuit in a circuit diagram and make it act like this circuit? Sounds like a neat challenge. Change the game play. Instead, I want a machine that can take a rest.Description of a sequence of steps. And that machine will now act like what is described as a machine. You can take a schedule, however you want to change how the application that exists will be interpreted in the same part of every computer. What it is doing is saying, change the game.Now an example of a storage program computer. What that means a storage program computer is that I can provide to the computer a sequence of instructions driving the process of one thing. And inside of the machine, and things we'll talk about, there is a process that will allow that sequence to be executed as described in the recipeLike any thing that I can describe on the graph. That actually seems like a really nice thing to have. Let me show you what that would basically look like. Inside of a storage program computer, you have the following. You have a memory. It's connected to a control unit.It's called an ALU, an arithmetic logic input. Get out of the input. Inside this source program computer, you have a sequence of instructions. The ordinary. Compatibility.